Hey, I'm a citizen. I have rights. You cannot detain me without charging me.
This I know.
And I know you're going to sit there quietly and wait with us like a good little watchmaker.
I've got this, Agent Riley. You and your partner can relax for a few minutes.
Wait a minute. I know you. You've been in my shop. What is this?
You have some things to answer for, Mr. Stanek. We have evidence linking you and your shop to the train station bombing.
Bombing? No! I would never... I wouldn't even know where to start. You have the wrong man.
I believe him.
Do I? Convince me. I have a timing device with your name on it, and I found the tools to make even more bombs in your apartment. What else am I supposed to think?
But you've been to my shop. You know I fix watches. I don't make bombs. No. Those tools aren't mine. They belong to my...
Your daughter?
No. No. Look. Take me. I'm the one you're looking for.
So she's
for,
the bomb maker.
I have made bombs for them.
I don't think so. Protecting your daughter is admirable, Mr. Stanek. But you're not doing her any good by taking the blame. You need to tell me what you know.
You're right, I know. Allison was in the military. She always wanted to belong, to be part of something greater than herself. She was such a beautiful child, gifted.
What happened?
After the incident, she met some people. They said they were her friends, but I could see they only wanted to use her. Parasites, and now they have taken her. You must help. She is not to blame.
We can help.
For this, she has been coerced.
Calm down. What do you mean they've taken her?
Allison and I were supposed to meet here tonight. Instead, one of them came by, spewing curses about fleshers and naturals. He gave me a message from her. She was saying goodbye. But she would never. They used her. And now they intend to make her disappear.
Well, we're going to have to save the day, I think.
Your apartment was booby-trapped by Radich Nikoladze.
What? Why would he... I guess friendship means nothing to a thug.
What happened?
I was never a wealthy man, but my shop is well-known and respected. Radich liked my watches. He knew I needed money after what happened to Allison, so we strike a deal. Deals are like beautiful women to that man. A better one always comes around.
Fair enough. Now, if she was in military and she's got watchmaking experience, it does sound like she's got the expertise to do this. Friends, they're not really our friends. They're just thugs and terrorists, so... Let's cut to the chase.
Where can I find Allison, Mr. Stanek?
I wish I knew. I would go and get her away from those people. I was about to go looking for her when your goon showed up.
We'll find her. I need you to go with these agents. I'll have some more questions for you.
No! I have to go! I have to help her! She's all I have.
We will help it.
Please,
Nomad.
Let us do our job.
Find my daughter, or I will!
We got this.
Smiley, I spoke to Stanek. He's not our guy, but he has a daughter, Allison, ex-military EOD. She might be the lawmaker.
So what's our next move?
Stanek says he doesn't know where she is, but I think he's hiding something. The agents are bringing them in. Until he gives her up, this investigation is stalled.
I'll make sure they lean on him, see what he knows.
Good. Let me know what happens.
Adam, Janice heard the NSM conversation and recovered.
Oh, that's convenient timing.
He agrees you two should meet.
Good. Just tell me where.
There's an abandoned tourist information center in the central plaza. Make sure you're not followed. And I got something on Marchenko for you, too.
Oh,
details
good.
Are on a pocket secretary near the meetup point. Look for a trash bin with a chalk mark above it. You'll find it near the metro.
Got it.
Couldn't just send me an email. Points of interest. Let's go see this dead drop and see what we can learn about Marchenko.
I can't believe it has come to this.
I bet it boils down to he's not a nice man. So we look for a bin with a chalk mark above it.
Seems as though there are more police than usual.
Right, there's a bin, but there's no chalk mark. But that's the kind of bin we're looking for. That was hard. Here's what we know. So he's Ukrainian. Left school after 10 years. 12 years or so where we've got no records for him. Wife and kid, but then they weren't with him when he emigrated. I'm wondering if he took someone else's name. And he's not the real Viktor Marchenko. Maybe. Anyway. We've got a building. How do we get into said building? We've got Janus to chat to. Oh, we just jumped through that narrow window. Very well. We don't appear to have a passcode for the door. Again. There appears to be no other way through other than getting through that door. Like, although, wait a minute. It's just an ordinary door. So we could always get through it that way. Hopefully Janus won't mind. Although, is this even where we need to be? Maybe not. Maybe this wasn't actually the point of interest, although... Maybe it is. Aha! Right, we'll put the gun away. We don't need it to kill Janus if he's a sussy backer. Right.
Janus, if this is your idea of a face-to-face meeting, I'm not impressed.
You didn't think I would jump on a plane to Prague, did you?
I guess not. That conversation we recovered, you know who Manderly was talking to, don't you?
Robert Page, CEO of Page Industries, Bob. Owner of the VersaLife Corporation. He's a multi-billionaire.
Doesn't mean we can't arrest both of them for conspiracy to commit murder. We heard Page give the order to kill Rucker.
In a recorded conversation that you obtained illegally. It's fruit from the poisonous tree, Mr. Jensen. It won't stand up in court.
What about this orchid, then? Can we find out more about it?
I think we should find out. I'm digging on my end, but there may be something you can do in Prague. VersaLife has an account at the Palisade Property Bank.
Uh-huh.
If you can get to their data vault, we may find some of the answers we're looking for.
You're telling me to break into a bank?
Again.
ARC is being manipulated, set up to take the fall for something. Most likely another terror attack.
Fine. What about this Brown? Page mentioned him and some sort of council. Nathaniel Brown, maybe, head of the Santo Group?
Perhaps. Nathaniel Brown stands to earn trillions if the Human Restoration Act passes, but...
Janus.
Adam, the site's been compromised. I
just
spotted sentry drones headed your way.
What? How? I wasn't followed.
Maybe somebody at PRE detected Janus' hack into the electrical grid. I don't know. Just get out of there.
Do we need to rush? Go ahead, just shut the door. Pop that in front of it and go out this little vent. Whee! Take that, drones. Now what? There's a little EMP thing there. Still not sure how we really use those. Do we just toss them at things? I mean, we could easily shoot these drones. We're a badass. But yeah, what does happen if we just toss this out? Does it do much? No. Whoop. Did we get away with that? Maybe. No, maybe we didn't. Take that, everything. Oh god, there's one behind us. That nearly worked. But because it didn't, let's try it the other way. Damn. That also didn't work. Maybe if we actually used some of our EMP ammo for a change. What's the button? Is it B? No. Is it... No. There's a button that lets us easily switch between different ammo types. I'm sure of it. Is it Y? There it is. EMP ammo. Okay, this doesn't seem to blow them up very quickly. That does say. Right, so it kind of slows them down a bit. At which point, we can then demolish them with the revolver. Now, where was that last one? That cheeky one. And then switch to the old revolver. Blam. Probably don't even need the EMP ammo. Could probably just revolver them. Yeah. By and large, that did the job. Oh well, thanks EMP ammo. I'm probably never using you again. Firing pattern, burst fire, semi-auto. Yeah, let's go back to semi-auto. I've never been a fan of burst fire in pretty much any game. Alright, and that lets us go around here. Where we find a safe. We haven't got many multi-tools left, so maybe we just move on with our lives. Who are you? Civilian, you say? Pretty cool looking for a civilian. We'll leave you be. We might even not rob too much of your stuff, although biosignals are useful. So maybe we'll take that. Mines. If only there was some way to trigger them all, he says as he fails to trigger them. There we go. That did it. Oh, we triggered a gas mine. Now, where is it? There it is. Is that just going to stay there now? Maybe? Nope, it's cleared. Good. Whole lot of traps in here. Do we even need to go that way? I mean, this way is electrical. So we're kind of alright on either, really. That guy's just stood there. Why are you all hanging around in this death trap, you lunatics? Let's see. Another gassy room? Maybe there's a valve down there somewhere? Maybe there's loot down there as well? Either way, we're past that obstacle. And we might be out. We can probably put our gun away. Is that where we raved earlier? It is.
Another one.
Mr. Jensen, it's Nomad Stanek. Please, please, you must help.
Oh, now you want to talk.
How did you...
My daughter. They're going to kill her. I gave your friends the slip, and when I got to here...
Where?
The Prakaska district. An apartment complex behind the laundromat. Please, hurry.
We can do that, old man. We got nothing else to do right now, have we? We still haven't been back to see the doc about my bloody augments and turning off the experimental settings. But hey ho. We press on.
Adam, you okay? Those drones.
I'm fine. Whoever sent them didn't succeed.
Oh, thank God for that. Listen, Janus just called. VersaLife is closing their account, moving everything out of that data vault tonight. This can't wait. You gotta get over there now.
I can't. I found the bomb maker. She can tell us everything. But she's about to be killed.
What? Shit, man. They're cleaning up loose ends. I can't break into a bank, not by myself. And if we don't do this now, we lose the Orchid. Fuck!
But if I don't go to the Prakaska district, the bomb maker dies, and we're back to square one.
Your call, man.
Aha! Now it's the bit where we get to choose a mission. Do we save the bomb maker? Or do we rob the bank? I think we rob the bank. Maybe Alex can help. Maybe she can deal with the old bomb maker for us. That'd be nice. Either way, we've got a heist to do.
Alex, did Janus actually have a plan for this robbery? Or does he expect me to shoot my way to the vault?
He had someone slip a package into the bank manager's car.
Someone?
It's parked in the employee parking garage. Let me know when you've got it. I'm glad you're doing this, Adam.
Good. She's happy. So we're happy. Right, we're in the old restricted zone once again. With a bunch of guard chaps around. They've replaced the ones from earlier, it seems. But they're all going to kick off when we activate car alarms. So, yeah. Let's try and be sneaky stealthy, shall we? While this pumping music continues to play. Now, what did this allow us to do? Sneak around to get the drop on this lad, maybe? Yeah.
Minor audio. I'll check.
You'll check nothing, friend.
Keep that it down.
Probably brutal. It's hard to tell. That was a bit clearer. And suddenly we're down to one. That guy's got a bank key card on him. Very nice. As is that guy. But we've already got a way in. So that's all good. Now, where are you facing, my friend? You're over there. Good. How would you like to be shanked? Didn't like it. Very well. You can come in here with your mates. Yeah, you sit by that locker. Which car trunk do we need to search? Do we need to worry about anyone coming in? Package from Janus. Bam.
Okay, Alex, I got the package. Now what?
There's supposed to be a data rod and an access card inside, but the card is blank. Jaina said we need to imprint it with biometrics from an active account holder.
So what? Kidnap somebody and steal their DNA?
Maybe next week. Tonight we can get what's needed from an office on the third floor. According to a contact, the bank keeps clients...
Cool. Let's just quickly add some more points into various things.
Profiles on a secure terminal there.
So all I gotta do is get through security to find it. Great.
We know how to get around the bank. Stop whining, Adam.
Absolutely secure. Data extractors have no...
Jensen, it's Smiley. Your friend, Nomad Stanek, escaped custody. Agent Riley said he was...
Yeah, I heard. His daughter's in trouble.
Trouble? What kind of trouble? You know where they are? Adam, you need to go find them, both of them, before it's too late.
I'm on it.
It's going to be too late. We can't do everything at once, and we don't want to let Alex down. Right, so how do we get back up to the third floor? I mean, I could have probably taken an elevator. But hey-ho. There's just rooms full of dead people around here, so we can... scoot past them. Yeah, maybe we just take the elevator. Because upstairs is probably full of dead people too, yeah?
Where are you, Mr. Jensen? You said you were coming.
I got caught up in something. I'll be there soon, Mr. Stanek.
There is no more soon. You are too late. My little girl is gone. She's gone to their ascension.
Mr. Stanek.
Oh dear.
Nomad.
Shit. Right. Oh, there's a camera up there. Oh well, this has all gone wrong. I was expecting dead people. I didn't realise they'd be back. Right, who's shooting me? Do I even need to worry about who's shooting me? This door locks again. Top stealth. That's what we've employed here.
Alex, you still with me? I'm accessing the biometric terminal now. How's this supposed to work?
The way Janus explained it, malware on the card will look for the profile of an authorized VersaLife representative and clone it.
I thought you said the card was blank.
Technically, I said it. Sorry. But the card should be active now. Find the elevator to the basement and try it.
Cool. Right, so we've got the VersaLife keycard. Oh god, there's a robot. Right, so the robot's checking out that guy. I keep pressing the wrong buttons. But let's go for some EMP ammo again. And then... that's the wrong button, but hey-ho. Let's switch to that. Have we got any piercing ammo? We have. Bam! Silently took down a robot. And then it exploded. Oh well. Oh god, we still got EMP ammo in the pistol. That's no good. And that's what got us killed.
Code zero. Back to post.
This time we're going to get this dude. Because we're going to go sneaky cheeky. And we're going to wait for him to come up the stairs. And then we're going to shank him. Coming up the stairs, friend? He's not even coming this time. So we can have some of that. Right, is anyone really going to care about us now? Kinda. Right, it's a turret there. Let's just cheese it, shall we? Okay, that didn't work either. Ah, god, I've got the wrong ammo on again. Pete's sake.
Moving in. Individual. Confirmed.
Come on. Poke that little head out.
Close ranks.
There we go. Center mass. Often the best way.
Grenade out.
It's not going to help when I'm over here, is it, chummer? Yeah, maybe we'll go out the sneaky way instead. That might make a bit more sense. Right, how far down can we go like this? We're on level one. We're in a room we shouldn't be in. Okay, there's a search going on. There's a robot over there. We probably don't want to be on level 1 again. We want to be on level 2. Because I'm thinking we don't want to go past that big turret that leads to the corporate vaults, when we could just quite as easily go through the car park. So yeah, not exactly top stealth. But lots of people are dead. So it's half successful. Right, and just like that, cameras are back to being friendly. And back down we go. So, if we jump over here and down. And what have we got? Terminals. I feel like there should be some way of getting into these without needing to hack things. Because that's why we went to all the effort of grabbing these key cards, right? Alright, this one's unlocked. Piker's vault. So we deploy the vault. And then we use the key card. Okay. We're in the Piker's vault. What's our fat loot? Bunch of hacking software, which I guess makes sense. Triangle code. A safe, which we would need to hack separately. Very well. Let's see. And there's a code for the computer, I think. Yes. Damage control. The org incident. So they're saying it was caused by Darrow. A secret solitary hero sacrificed himself to save the world. Who could that be? Yeah. Truth doesn't really matter once you've got someone to blame. And now Bob's emailing people. But yeah, a whole bunch of stuff about manipulating the media. As one might expect from Pikers. And let's hack in their safe and see what real goodies we've got. Multi-tools. 3 of the buggers. And credit chips for days. Nice. Suddenly the Pikers vault was worthwhile after all. Right, so let's us see. So we can't undeploy the vault. Once it's open, it's open. But I guess that's how we get into the other vaults then, is we find the terminal, we deploy them, so they're poking out the wall, and then we can access their goodies. Tava security. A silencer, a pocket sec. Right, security concerns. I bet. What is that? The Cote d'Azur combat rifle. All right. A laser targeting system. Can we do anything with that? Oh, we could put a laser target on our pistol. That might be nice. Now, what's so special about this Cote d'Azur? 15, 60, 80, 60, 30, 40. Compared to our current combat rifle. Seems generally better. 25, 30, 58, 49, 16, 55. Yeah. That's just a better combat rifle than our current one. But it can't be upgraded at all. But it's already got a silencer by the look of it. And yeah, it's already maxed out on everything. EMP ammo. Does that mean it can only be used with EMP ammo? Yeah, it's only EMP. Full auto. Damn. That's a shame. It'd be very cool if it had, like, regular ammo. Take a bit more revolver ammo for sure. So once again, we've got access to a compult. Bunch of chat logs of them being awful buggers. Very well. Revolver ammo. And what else? Nothing else? Just revolver ammo in the safe. Okay. I guess the fancy sniper rifle was the main prize. Garvin Quinn. Master of disguise. Master of Irish accents. So what we got left? Tai Yong and Versalife, I guess. So let's deploy old Tai Yong. We've had the card for this one for bloody forever. And now what fat loot have we got? We got biocells. We got nanoblade augmentation prototypes. And that'll just be more plot gubbins, I guess. Emails regarding Hugh Darrow and Panchea. It's an old email. Curious. Tesla cartridges. That is of no use to me. Nanoblade ammo. That's kind of useful. One of these weird meaty boys. We're familiar with them. Typhoon ammo. That's useful for us. So this is all relating to augments and whatnot. Let's pop open this safe. Praxis! A neuroprazine. Lovely. Now, let's get explosive heat blades. Hold discharge, release to fire. Yeah. Now we can blow up our nano blades that we'll probably forget to use for the entirety of the playthrough. And that leaves us with one more vault, which is the actual plot one. So where do we go to get to it? Is it this? Oh, that's for a laser. Why would we want to turn on a laser? Maybe it can't be accessed in the same way as the other three, because it's so plot relevant. I was under the impression that all four vaults were dealt with in the same way, which is why I saved the key cards for the others. But I'm not seeing anywhere where the other vault could be activated. So maybe we do have to go out and follow the quest markers. Oh well, at least the bank's calmed down now. So let's see what's what. Okay, now it's all kicking off again. Very well. That's fine, we'll just sneak down.
The access card worked, Alex. I'm in the elevator, heading down.
Janus is good, man. He said security measures prevent wireless communications near the vault, so you and I will lose contact soon.
Meaning I'll be on my own from here on in.
Just until you enter the Versalife vault and plug the data rod into their terminal. Janus should be able to contact you directly once it's installed. He had me load a bunch of malware on it. Of course, you have to reach the vault access room and call down the Versalife vault first. If you're stopped by security... This is
basically a date. If we're stopped by security, we'll kill them all, Alex. It's kind of what we do. And those are the ones with the most to hide. Yeah, we got some sneaking to do now.